Hi students, yesterday discussed about simple topic. One is stationary waves formed in stretched string and another stationary waves formed in open tubes and also closed tube, and also discussed about beads. These four questions are important 8 marks questions and also important topics for JEE mains and NEET examinations. Okay students, today discuss about Doppler effect. This is 8 marks topic, Doppler effect. Doppler effect, this effect discovered by Doppler. So what is Doppler effect? First of all, first definition. Actually, S is the source of sound. O is an observer. Observer means the sound heard by one person, that is called observer. But what is source? The sound produced by one machine, like train engine, that is also one of the machine. Okay, the ringing bell is also machine. This is called source. The sound produced by one machine, that is called source. S is the source, O is the observer. Suppose for example, source approaches the an observer, frequency is increases. Away from an observer, frequency is decreases. And then the sound frequency heard by an observer sometimes increases for approaches and decreases away from the observer. In both cases, first case increases and second case decreases. So that apparent change in frequency. So the definition is very simple. Okay, an operant frequency of sound heard by an observer due to relative motion between source and observer is called Doppler effect. So I repeat once again, definition is a very simple definition. An operant change in frequency heard by an observer due to relative motion between source and observer is called Doppler effect. Sir, what is the best example of Doppler effect? It's a very simple example. Suppose one train engine, the whistling of train engine approaches an observer. Observer at railway platform. The frequency of sound is, the observer heard frequency is increases in case of approach. Suppose in case of away from the observer, frequency is decreases. So this is the best example of the Doppler effect. This is first example. But second example, it is also very simple. Suppose source is at rest, can produce sound. Observer approaches the source, frequency is increases. Away from the source, frequency is decreases. This both are best examples of Doppler effect. Sir, what is Doppler shift? Okay, the difference between apparent frequency and original frequency of sound, it is called Doppler shift. The difference between apparent frequency and original frequency of sound, it is called Doppler shift. And also, what is Doppler limit? It's a very simple one, limit of Doppler effect. Limit of Doppler effect. The velocity of sound, Vs, and velocity of observer, V0, must and should be less than of velocity of sound. Must be less than velocity of sound. This is called limit of Doppler effect. Okay, now discuss about first case, case 1. Okay. Source is in motion and observer is at rest. Now discuss about, it's a simple topic. Source is in motion and observer at rest. Okay students, but source is in motion but observer is at rest. Okay, suppose first point, S be the source of sound, O be the observer. Sir, velocity of source is Vs, observer velocity is V0. But in this case, observer is a crest, so V naught is equal to 0. The frequency of source is n. So source produced n number of waves in 1 second. So that is the frequency of source. Suppose, okay, if the time period t, second point, at time period t, okay, the source produced one sound wave, okay, traveling with velocity v, covered distance lambda. The distance between source and observer is lambda. At the same time, the source moving with velocity vs, after t seconds, okay, the source is at s dash. So the distance covered source vs into t. Vs into t. First, the sound wave covered the distance is lambda, and the source covered the distance is vs into t. So third point, the apparent change in wavelength lambda dash. Students, we know that this is lambda, this is vs into t, this is lambda dash, but this is called apparent change in wavelength. Apparent wavelength lambda dash is equal to lambda minus vs into t. That's okay. Students, we know that every person, but lambda is equal to v by n, and time period t is equal to 1 by n. This both values are substituted in above equation. Lambda dash is equal to v by n minus vs by n. So is equal v minus vs by n. This is apparent change in wavelength. Lambda dash is equal to v minus vs by n. Students, very simple. Apparent change in wavelength lambda dash is equal to lambda minus vs into t. But we know that every person lambda is equal to v by n, t is equal to 1 by n. After simplification, lambda dash is equal to v minus vs by n. So now, last point, apparent change in frequency. Apparent change in frequency n dash is equal v by lambda dash. Just substitute the lambda dash value is equal v by v minus vs by n. It's okay. N comes to numerator. N dash is equal v by v minus vs into n. This is the apparent frequency in case of source is in motion but observer is at rest. Okay, by this equation, apparent change in frequency is always greater than actual frequency of n. In this case, apparent change in frequency is always greater than actual frequency of n. Oh, but next, another case, suppose source is in moving away from an observer. So it's very simple, Nana. Source away from an observer. Away from an observer means Vs is equal to minus Vs. But we know that every person, V naught is equal to 0. This value substitute in above equation, N dash is equal V by V minus, minus into minus plus V plus Vs into N. Okay, students. Then first case, N dash greater than N. But students, say second case, N dash less than N. What is the meaning of N dash less than N? Apparent change in frequency is less than always actual frequency. In the case of away from an stationary observer, this is the most important 8 marks topic. Students, once repeat, same topic. First point is very simple. S is the source of velocity Vs. O and observer of velocity is V naught, but is it at rest? So V naught is equal to 0. So next is source frequency is N. One sound wave to reach an observer in 1 second. The distance covered by the sound wave is lambda. At the same time, the source covered the distance Vs into T. So
apparent change in frequency lambda dash is equal to lambda minus Vs into T. Okay, lambda dash is equal to V minus Vs by N. This value substitute in apparent change in frequency, N dash is equal to V by lambda dash is equal to V by V minus Vs by N. N comes to numerator. So N dash is equal to V by V minus Vs into N. From this equation, operant change in frequency is always greater than actual frequency. But in another case, source away from stationary observer. So we know that source moving in opposite direction, so Vs is equal to minus Vs. This value substitute in above equation, N dash is equal to V by V plus Vs into N. So students, apparent frequency is always less than original frequency. This is the simple topic. Sir, what is the definition of Doppler effect? The apparent change in frequency here by an observer due to relative motion between source and observer is called as Doppler effect. Sir, what is the limit? Velocity of source and velocity of observer is always less than velocity of sound. Okay. Doppler shift. Okay, students. Doppler shift. This is also another important 8 marks topic. Doppler shift. Sir, what is Doppler shift first of all? Simple. Okay. The apparent frequency. This is apparent frequency N dash. The original frequency is N. So the difference between apparent frequency and original frequency is called as Doppler shift. The difference of apparent frequency and original frequency of sound is called Doppler shift. So today discuss about another case. Source is in rest. Source is at rest now, S. An observer is moving with velocity V naught. An observer moving with velocity V naught. The velocity of sound is V. The velocity of sound is how much? V. It's okay. The frequency of sound is, source of sound is M. Okay, this is the simple first point. Students, S be the source of sound is at rest. So Vs is equal to 0. Okay, observer is moving with velocity V naught. V be the velocity of sound. N is the frequency of source of sound. Lambda is the wavelength of sound. So second point, it's a very simple. An observer, observer taken excess number of waves because observer approach the stationary source. Observer approach the stationary source means, suppose for example, away from the stationary source, decrease the number of waves, but approach the stationary source, excess number of waves here an observer. That is the most important thing in this case. So the second point is very simple. Okay, suppose how much distance, the distance covered by an observer, the distance covered by an observer in 1 second is V naught. Simple. The distance covered by an observer in 1 second is V naught. Okay. Suppose excess number of waves here an observer in the same time. Excess number of waves, here an observer at the same time. So excess number of waves, we know that every person, V naught by lambda. This is called excess number of waves. So third point, this is most important thing. The apparent change in frequency, N dash is equal to original frequency plus excess number of waves frequency V naught by lambda. It's okay. But we know that every person, N dash is equal to what is the value of N? V by lambda plus V naught by lambda. That is equal to V plus V naught by lambda. It's okay.
This is called apparent frequency. N dash is equal to V plus V naught by lambda. But lambda is equal to V by N. N is the actual frequency. Substitute in this equation, N dash is equal to V plus V naught by V by N. N comes to numerator, N dash is equal to V plus V naught by V into N. This is the apparent change in frequency equation. From this equation, apparent change in frequency is always greater than original frequency. This is original frequency, nothing but actual frequency. So next, another important. This is suppose observer away from the stationary source. Observer away from the stationary source. Stationary source means this is S, Vs is equal to 0. This is observer V naught. Away from the, so V naught is equal to minus V naught. This value substitute in above equation, N dash is equal V minus V naught by V into M. Students, okay, in first case, numerator is positive, so that apparent change in frequency is increases. Students, in this case, numerator is negative, so that apparent change in frequency is decreases. So, apparent frequency is always decreases with actual frequency. This is the simple, another 8 marks topic. Students, very simple topic, Doppler shift. The difference of apparent change in frequency and original frequency is called Doppler shift. Okay, source S, first point. S be the source of sound. S, the velocity Vs is equal to 0 because it is at rest. Then N is the frequency of source of sound. O is the observer. Okay, with the moving velocity V naught. V be the velocity of sound. V be the velocity of sound. It's no problem. So this is very simple. Extra number of waves. Here an observer in this case. First observer, okay, then reach you extra number of waves, that is V naught by lambda. So that apparent change in frequency N dash is equal to original frequency plus extra number of waves frequency V naught by lambda. Original frequency V by lambda, extra number of waves frequency V naught by lambda. So N dash is equal to V plus V naught by lambda. But lambda is equal to V by N. We get answer N dash is equal to V plus V naught by V into N. So N dash greater than N. This is in this case N dash less than N. Okay students, then listen carefully for second point, is very very important. Okay, an observer moving with the velocity V naught, okay, towards the stationary source. For 1 second, okay, for 1 second the observer covered the distance is V naught, that's no problem. But observer heard extra number of waves in 1 second, that is V naught by lambda. So apparent change in frequency by the observer N dash is equal to original frequency plus extra number of waves frequency V naught by lambda. Okay students.